Astronaut Scott Kelly is back on Earth after a record-setting trip to the International Space Station.
Hey, after nearly a year in space, Kelly and two Russian cosmonauts landed in Kazakhstan last night. Their goal, to see how their bodies handled that much time in space, something we need to know before a mission to Mars. So how many people have gone to space? Good question. And Heather, there are still actually people in space right now.
Right. So how many people are in space right now? Well, last night there were six. Now, there are three, an American, a Russian, and the first ever Brit. But in about 2 weeks, another three astronauts will head back up to the International Space Station, leaving them with their normal full load. What does it take to become an astronaut?
A lot.
I would say a dream.
I think you got to have a pretty open mind.
Space is defined as being 100 kilometers above the surface, or 60 miles.
Ron Schmidt is the observatory coordinator at Jackson Middle School.
So anytime you're above that, you're in space.
The International Space Station,
I'm a big believer in what we're doing here,
is about 250 miles away.
How many people have been to space?
There have been about 550.
Cool, though. It's an exclusive club.
To see the type of person that can take challenges and overcome them, who can cope with adversity and adapt, those are the kind of people they want.
About two-thirds of space travelers have been Americans. The vast majority were astronauts with at least 2 years of training. But there have been a handful of space tourists, some scientists and engineers.
We've had, like, the prince from Saudi Arabia.
And a half dozen or so Air Force pilots.
That have flown their high-performance rocket planes above that altitude. And so even though they didn't fly for NASA, they got astronaut wings.
Oh, wow.
You get up above that altitude, they count.
That's one small step for man.
Astronauts haven't left the Earth's orbit since their sixth and final moon landing in 1972.
Only 12 people walked on the surface of the moon. Of the 7 billion people on the planet, that's it.
There were 135 shuttle missions up until that program's end in 2011, which now leaves the space station as the only place to visit.
If we go up, it's to the station. We connect to the station, and then we spend several months up there. And right now, we're getting a ride with the Russians.
Now the next mission in the works is to explore the space between the Earth and the Moon. And then, of course, the trip to Mars, which is likely a good 15 years away still. Now, some commercial trips have been planned. Those would be very short visits for lots and lots of money. But none of those have taken off quite yet. So, I mean, I don't
know. That's interesting.
It really
is. I didn't realize that.
No, that I had no idea about a lot of this. It's interesting because what they said is, you know, when we were going to the moon, everyone knew about the space program. And now, not quite as many people know much about it.
It's fascinating to learn how many people have been to the moon and other places.
Right. Would you go to space?
I can't imagine passing up the opportunity.
I know.
I don't know if I have the guts.
I could do the 344 days in space, but
quick trip.
Right.
Thanks, Heather. Mm-hmm.
If you have a good question for Heather, please email it by going to WCCO.com/links. All right, we all know.